Hi brothers and sisters, welcome back. In this video session we will going to talk about what is default method and static method. Till Java 7 we can declare a method in an interface. We need to provide a implementation of the method in classes using implements keyword. Using implements keyword you can attach a particular interface in a class, then you need to provide an implementation of method which is declared in the interface. This is the high level concept of interface. If you want to know about, if you want to learn more about the interface, there are some other video I have uploaded, please look at. I have provided those links in this video comment section itself. In this video you will going to talk about only what is default method and static method. Here I have created an interface called shape interface. That interface having a two method, draw circle, draw rectangle. I have provided the implementation of this method in three different classes: shape type 1, shape type 2, shape type 3. Okay, three different classes I have given an implementation. Shape type 1 I given a draw circle, drawing circle from shape type 1, drawing circle from shape type 1. Similarly here also shape type 2. Drawing rectangle for shape type 2. Drawing circle for shape type 3. Okay. The three, whatever method declared here, I have provided the implementation for three different classes. Let's say I want to enhance shape type 1 and shape type 2. I want to introduce a new functionality for shape type 1, shape type 2. I don't want to introduce new functionality in shape type 3. Okay, but still you need to add a one more method, draw oval. Now I need to based on my requirement, the draw oval should implemented in shape type 1 and shape type 2. Okay, but Java compiler throwing the error for three different classes, all of these classes. This is the Java compiler expecting implementation for draw oval, implementation for draw oval three different classes. This is a big design issue in Java 7. Whenever you change, whenever you added new method in your interface, that interface should be implemented in all the classes attached to the interface. This is a big design issue. To fix this issue, Java 8 introduced new method called default method. New method called default method. We can provide method implementation itself in an interface using default method. Now I'll going to add one keyword called default, then you need to provide an implementation. Before the signature you need to add a keyword, that's it. This is default implementation of oval. Okay, see, once we added the default implementation of a draw oval, all of these classes not showing the error. All of these classes not showing the error. Now this draw oval method should, this draw oval method is visible for all three different classes. This is the purpose of default method. Default method. This is the purpose of default method. Now whenever you call this draw vowel method through type 1, type 2, type 3, this is the method get invoked. This is the method get invoked. Again, in future, again later point of the time, I need unit implementation for draw vowel for shape type 2. For shape type 1, this implementation is enough. But for shape type 2, I need different implementation. In this case, I can override this default method in your class. Override implements method. This is own implementation of shape type 2. The shape type 2 class draw. I'm overriding draw vowel method. And I am providing my own implementation for shape type 2 class. Whenever you call draw vowel method through shape type 1, shape type 3, you will be getting the default implementation. Whenever you call draw vowel through shape type 2, you will be getting its own implementation. In this example, we saw that without breaking existing functionality, I have introduced new functionality called drawVowel. This is the purpose of default method. Before going to start static method, we'll going to execute this program. I have created a new class called ShapeCaller, where I want to invoke three implementation method. When I look at this particular code, I am calling here drawVowel. The drawVowel is a common implementation method for all three classes, but in shape type 2 I have given my own implementation. Okay, when I execute this program, see, yeah, this is default implementation of vowel. This is own implementation of vowel from shape type 2, right? This is default implementation of vowel. When I call shape type 2, it has its own implementation of shape type 2. This is the purpose of default method. I hope you people understand what is the use of default method. Now we are going to talk about static method. In a shape interface, I am going to define a new static method. I have already written that method. I don't want to waste your time by writing a code. Okay. Here I have defined a new method called getColors. GetColors, that colors return map object. That map object contains a list of colors. If you want to create a static method, we need to add a static keyword before of your method signature. That's it. Now I'm going to say about what is the difference between default method and static method. Default method you can override. Static method you cannot override. Static method act as a utility method used in across your implementation class. In the case of default method, you can override, you can provide unique implementation to in your implementation class. That is not possible in the case of static method. Static method we cannot override. If you want to call static method, you need to say like this: interface name dot that static method. Interface name dot that static method. Now shape.getColors return all the color informations. Now in a type 1, let's say I'll go into the shape type 1. Here you can call your static method like this: shape1.getColors. I want to retrieve particular color for this shape. So get colors dot get red. GetColor is a static method coming from shape interface. I am calling the GetColors. That GetColors returns map object. That map object, I am using a get method to retrieve the particular color. The same thing here. So this is the purpose of static method. Static method act as a utility method for your implementation class. Static method cannot be override in your implementation class. This is the purpose of static method. Now I'll going to execute this program. I'm going to shape color. The shape color I am calling shape dot get colors, and the shape type one, the two implementation method I am calling a get colors. Through that I am fetching particular color. See here, drawing circle shape type one red, here type one orange. In shape type two also I am calling, in shape type 2 also I am calling the get colors. Okay, in shape color int of the line I just calling shape dot get colors, so it's returning the all the colors. I hope you people understand what is the use of a default method and a static method. We will going to talk about some other topic in next video session. Until then, bye from Suresh Kesavan.